What happened to Danny Pedrosa in Qatar? He qualified 14th and finished 11th. In Japan, he qualifies 11th. What happened? Pedrosa was racing injured in the second half of 2008. When he crashed out of the lead in Germany in July, he broke several bones in his hands and wrist. He crashed again in Australia in October, a knee injury which required surgery in the winter. By March and the pre-season test in Qatar, he was almost back to full fitness. Then he crashed heavily and re-injured the knee, which had just been repaired.
Just getting a little bit more used to ride, because long time not riding that fast, and I need more laps.
Pedrosa ruled the world in the smaller categories, but he's fast becoming MotoGP's chronically wounded warrior. Maybe the big bikes are a step too far for the diminutive Spaniard. He's by far the smallest rider in the Premier class. Some say this gives him an advantage. Because he's lighter, he can accelerate faster. But really, it's a disadvantage. Taller riders with longer arms and legs can muscle the MotoGP machines around more easily. Stoner and Rossi are still a step ahead of Lorenzo. Stoner's qualifying time is just 0.05 of a second slower than Rossi's. Lorenzo is half a second down. Then he makes a bad start. The pressure's on.
I didn't do a very good start. I finished the first lap in fourth. I had to ride as best as I can to get the victory.
Japan, home to Yamaha, home to Bridgestone, the perfect stage. It's been a year since you won a race. There are three riders between you and the top step of the podium. Time to attack.
We'll be right back.
Danny Pedrosa, back on the fourth row. Injuries may slow you down later in the race, but what's to stop you making a flying start? 10 riders ahead of you on the grid. How many after two corners? Nobody expected to see Danny Pedrosa in second place, least of all Valentino Rossi, who's looking at the Spaniard's back wheel with just a few laps to go.